following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
A man in the can has some strange plan. There's something rash going on in the trash. Come with me. Construction, crane crossing, caution, careful. Coming closer causes catastrophes. Oh, no, let's find out. Oscar!
Hey, what's the matter? Can't you read signs?
Well, yeah, I can read them, but I don't know what they mean.
It means just what they say. You're on a construction site.
A construction site?
Yeah, lots of work going on here. I decided to enlarge my pool, so I had to bring in some heavy construction machinery to do the job.
Machinery?
Yeah. Sure. Bulldozers, earth movers. Cranes.
Oh, come, wait a minute, Oscar. You can't get a crane down there. A crane's too big, goes up like that. You don't have room for a crane down there.
Who says I can't?
Oh, no, you can't.
Okay, swing a little higher to the left. All right, that's it. A little higher. Higher.
Look, I still find it hard to believe that Oscar has a crane down there, but if you happen to be looking for a good C word, you know, a word that begins with the letter C, crane is a good C word, okay? And take a look at these signs again. Construction, crane, crossing, caution, careful, coming, closer, causes, catastrophes. Every one of those words begins with the letter C. Right, Oscar?
Correct. Give me my helmet, quick. Here we go. Okay. All right, now. Swing that crane above the dump truck and release the rocks!
So you can tell that C is a very important letter, right? Because C is in, well, it begins words like can. It's can that Oscar lives in. Also, cardboard carton. They both begin with the letter C. And, wait, what's he up to now? Hey, Oscar! Oscar! What's that noise?
Speak up! I can't hear you!
I said, what's that noise?
I'm drilling! Solid rock down there!
Oh, Well, look, there are lots of sounds along this street. I guess one more won't matter.
Hey, Oscar, you know what Gordon told me. He said that you were carrying on construction in your trash can. I don't hear anything.
Ah, Susan. It's terrible.
What's
really terrible?
Terrible. What?
That rock down there is even harder than I thought. I know what I'm going to have to do.
What? What are you going to have to do?
Blast!
Blast?
Blast.
Oh, come on, Oscar. You're not going to set off a dynamite charge in your trash can.
I'm going to have to blast the rock.
Oscar, that's not going to be safe.
Oh, don't try to stop me. It's going to have to be done. Okay. Everybody stand back. Stand back, everybody.
Tell me twice.
Are you ready? 3, 2, 1.
Oscar? Oscar, are you all right? Speak to me, Oscar. Are you all right?
I think maybe you're right, Susan. I'll have to get along without the new pool.
Oh, my goodness. I think maybe that's best. Don't you, Oscar?
Whew. Hey, we're just about to play a little game here, so why don't you join us? Everybody ready here?
Yeah.
All right. Now, we have some pictures, and we're going to look at them and decide which picture should come first, which should come second, and which should come third, okay?
Yeah.
All right. Now, here's a picture of some logs burning, right?
Mm-hmm.
And here's a picture of a tree.
Tree,
right? And here's a picture of some logs. Now, we have logs burning in a fireplace, picture number one, a tree for the second one, and some logs. Now, which do you think should come first? Ronald?
The tree.
The tree should come first. Okay, because that's where wood comes from, right?
Yeah.
Now, will they be burning next?
No.
They wouldn't be burning next. What's Ford?
The logs come next.
The logs come next. Mm-hmm. Why would the logs come next?
Because after you cut down a tree,
That's right.
Yeah, just cut down the tree.
You cut down the tree and then you stack the logs up, right?
And then you get the fire.
And then after you have them all stacked up, then you can use them to burn in your fireplace.
Mm-hmm.
So this one comes before all the rest and the rest come after, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Want to do it again?
Yeah.
I've got some more pictures here.
Good.
Okay. Now, here we have a little bird sitting on a branch. And next picture is a bird's egg.
That looks like a robin egg.
It does look like a robin's egg. And what do you know? There's a robin. Okay? First picture, bird sitting on a branch. Second picture, a robin's egg. And the third picture, a full-grown robin, right? Now, which picture should come first?
The egg.
Kate?
The egg.
The egg, right. Why would it be an egg first?
Because before he's born, it's an egg.
That's right, because birds come from eggs, right?
Uh-huh.
Now, which would come next, the big robin or the baby?
The baby.
The baby would come next, right? Because the baby bird would come out of the egg, huh?
And the big person is last.
And the big bird is last.
Like Big Bird.
Hey, just like Big Bird. Right, Ron. So we have the egg, and then the baby comes out of the egg, and then the last we have the full-grown robin, right?
Why doesn't the baby bird has yellow on them?
Have yellow?
Yeah.
Yeah, they sort of do have yellow, don't they? Shall we do another one?
Yeah.
Okay.
This last
hey, you're really getting very good at this. How are you doing, Huh? Okay, last one.
It's warm in here.
This is, Yeah, it's a nice sunny day here. Milk carton and a cow and a boy drinking milk. Now, which would come before all the others? Kate.
The cow.
The cow would come first. Why would the cow come first?
Because the milk comes from the cow.
Because the milk has to come from the cow, right? Now, what comes next here? The boy drinking the milk?
No.
Ford?
The milk carton.
The milk carton, because what?
After the cow, it goes into the milk carton.
After it comes out of the cow, goes into the milk carton, right? And then what happens after that?
The boy drinks it.
Sure, he goes down to the store and buys the milk out of the cart, and then he drinks it for lunch or breakfast, right?
Yeah. What's that?
Oh, I don't know, maybe some crackers. So we've got the cow first, and then the milk carton, and then the boy drinking, right?
Right.
Ah, that's very, very good. So all... Now, in each of these cases here, the first picture comes before... Are you listening? Because I'm going to ask you about this.
Yeah.
Now, in each of these cases, the first picture comes before the others, and all the other pictures come after the first picture. So this is before and after, right? You got that straight?
Woe with me.
Whoa. Well, what's the matter, Big Bird?
Oh, Gordon, it's terrible.
What's terrible?
It's awful.
What is?
I must be about the silliest, funniest looking bird on Sesame Street.
Oh, Big Bird, for an 8-foot bird, you look just fine. I don't see what the problem is. Why do you say that?
Gordon, in the haberdashery store, I saw this tie. It looked so nice in the window, I rushed in and bought it. But on me, my neck is so long, it just looks silly, 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 silly.
Oh, come on, Big Bird. Come on, Big Bird. It's not that bad. Your neck looks fine. Let me say that. Your neck looks fine.
It's too long, Gordon.
No, the tie is too short.
It is?
Oh, yeah. You see, you have a long neck, so you should have a long tie. There's nothing wrong with the neck. There's something wrong with the tie. That guy probably saw you coming down there in the haberdashery store. Now, look, here's a way about the way a tie hangs on, let's say, on me, right?
Oh. Say, right, it looks there. Quite smart right. On you, Gordon.
Like that? Beautiful tie. Yeah, but that's too short for you. For your neck, see, because your neck is very long. What you could use, I just happen to have a scarf here. You could use a scarf like this, bend down a little bit. Okay, good. And throw it over there and give you a bit of flare and dash.
Oh.
Now you should see yourself.
It looks good?
Oh, does it look good, Big Bird?
And my neck doesn't look too long?
Oh, no. You see, now you have a scarf, a long scarf that comes down and covers your long, slender, graceful, distinguished neck.
Whoa.
Right, sure, look at it now. See, your neck is not too long, Big Bird. See, it doesn't really matter what size the parts of the body are, as long as they all fit together.
Gosh, Gordon.
Hmm.
I just noticed something about the parts of the body.
What's that?
Well, there's lots of twos of everything.
Twos, like we just saw?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Like, for instance, I have two ears.
You do?
Well, they're covered up with feathers, so you can't see them.
Oh, I see.
But I can hear you.
Yeah.
And I have two eyes.
Two eyes.
To see you with.
Yes.
Better to see you with.
Right.
I have two parts to my beak.
Two parts?
Mm-hmm. See?
Top part, bottom part. One,
right.
Two. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's two all parts of your beak.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And I have two wings, see?
Your two wings.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Okay.
And I have two legs.
Yeah, you have two legs.
I have two feet.
You have 2 feet, that's right.
And on each foot, I have 1, 2, 3 toes.
Yeah.
I can't do anything right, can I?
Well, I'll tell you, you're not the only one with that problem, Big Bird, because Ernie's got his troubles too, you know.
Oh?
Oh, yeah.
We are going to play a game. We haven't played one in a long time in my store. And I'd like you to keep your eyes in this area. This is what the game is all about, yes? Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same, but one of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play our game. Play our game. Can you guess which one of these things doesn't belong here? By the time I finish my song, take a look now, take a good look. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Tell me, did you guess which one? If you guess that this thing doesn't belong here, you're right. Now my song is done. Well, it is the car that doesn't belong here. You know why? Because the zebra, the lion, the elephant are all in the animal family, and the car isn't.
How about another game, huh? I'm ready. Good.
Keep your eyes here. Ready? Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. But one of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play the game. Play the game. Could you guess which one doesn't belong here? By the time I finish my song, take a look now. Take a good look. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Tell me, did you guess which one? If you guess that this thing doesn't belong here, you are right. And my song is done. Right. This is a paper. This is a magazine. This is a book. It's all reading material. But this is an ice cream cone. It doesn't belong here, but, oh, it tastes good.
We were just talking. This is Susie. This is Kevin. This is Rico, and that's Kevin. And we were just talking about families, and we were asking how many people in families. And we're going to play a game about families. There's something wrong with the pictures I have on my lap. They show family groups, but there's one person or animal in each family that doesn't belong. So we're going to look at them, and let's see if you can pick them out. Okay. Who sees the little person in that family that doesn't belong, or the animal? Okay, why? What are these two? The mommy is what? Do you know what that is? Mm-hmm. What kind of animal is that?
Monkey.
Yeah, a type of monkey. She's called a gibbon, and this is a little baby gibbon. That's a type of a monkey, but Kevin, what kind of animal is that? Do you know?
It's a leopard.
It's a leopard, a baby leopard. So he just came to visit. He doesn't really belong in that family. Okay, what about this one, gang?
Fish.
The fish. What are the other two?
Dolphins.
Dolphins, and they're different than fish. They're mammals, right, and the fish is not a mammal. Hey, you guys are smart. I didn't think you'd know about dolphins. Okay, what about this group?
Raccoon.
That's not a raccoon.
That's a porcupine.
That's a porcupine, yeah. What's the difference in a raccoon and a porcupine?
Raccoon has quills and...
No, a raccoon has the... looks like a... Raccoon looks like the bandit with the little mask and has regular fur. The porcupine has the quills. These are the quills. We had one on Sesame Street one day.
What?
A porcupine? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, whoops. Dropping my picture. Okay, who came to visit in this picture?
The duck.
Doesn't belong there with those two penguins, a mother penguin and the baby. Hey, Susie, how many people in your family?
Five.
Rico, how many in your family?
Seven.
How many in your family?
Kevin? Five.
Well, there are two people in my family. How many in yours?
And family is a word that starts with the letter F, like fly and frog.
F's our letter. It's all wow. Come on, F, show us how.
Hey, 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 hey.
Hey, F is also for fingers, and fingers are what you use when you play an instrument like the ukulele. Listen, don't eat ukuleles. They taste rotten. They really do. Even Oscar doesn't eat ukuleles. We gotta go, but you come back and join us as soon as you want to. As soon as you can. We'll be here. You'll be here, too. See you later.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters C, F, and I, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Mm-hmm.
produces NET, the Public Television Network.